Hey guys, this is the second part of a two-part discussion I did with Az from HeelvsBabyface. To see part one of the discussion, go to his channel, I'll put the link in the description below. Also, I'd like to apologise for my microphone quality in advance, because I've had a lot of computer issues recently and Skype kept changing my levels, so there's a bit of background noise, but I hope you enjoy regardless. I think my problem with raiding is there's so many difficulties.
Yeah.
So there's far too many. I really liked the system that they had in Vanilla and the Burning Crusade, where you would, where there was like one raid difficulty, and you would kind of progress from one raid to the other. It felt like each raid was relevant for the entire expansion.
Yeah.
And even if in the Burning Crusade, for example, not many people got to see Sunwell, I like that there was always something to shoot for. The ceiling was really high in terms of raiding. Even if you could never see that content, it was still there for you to go and do if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Whereas I feel as though that's not the case anymore because people can see that content through LFR and stuff, and it's a lot more.
Why would you bother shooting for a heroic or mythic or even normal level raiding guild when you've seen it all through LFR?
And I feel as though that has a lot to do with retention as well, because people burn through this content so quickly. It doesn't retain players as much, because once you've downed all of that stuff once, why would you wait around for 12 months until the next expansion?
But WoW's trying to do its raiding how a lobby-based game does its content, and it's not working. Like a lobby-based game, you get together with, you know, three or four of the players. There's no technical tanks, there's no technical healers, but certain classes can do a little bit of this, certain classes can do a little bit of that, you know. A spellcaster will like throw some heals every now and again just to top everybody up, but you're pretty much all DPS and wrecking shit. And then it's like a bang, bang, bang. We do this zone, we kill the end boss. Has it dropped loot? No. Has it dropped loot for you? Yeah, I got something. Okay, and then you teleport out or whatever, and then you reset the instance and you go back in. It's a lobby-based game. Fantasy Star Online.
I see what you mean there.
Monster Hunter Online. But with World of Warcraft, you have this complex leveling, the complex raiding system that has LFR, normal, heroic, and mythic. And LFR is just fucking cancer. And then let's face it. I could have it's just shit. It needs to die. And then you've got normal raiding, which involves definite cooperation, communication, and is a huge leap up from LFR. There's no comparison between LFR and normal raiding at all. There is a huge leap in difficulty between the two.
And for some videos, dude, I go into LFR and I like get panning shots and stuff, and I just leave my character standing there. And by the time the fight's over, I'll still be alive.
Oh yeah, yeah. I did some LFR this week. On stream, and it's just like I was just chatting to my stream. I did hardly anything, and it was just, you know, there's no point. It's irrelevant content, put it that way. It's irrelevant content that shows your hand in the raid, so it's just so counterproductive, it's unreal. But then you've got your normal and your mythic. So once, let's say a guild is good enough to do normal raiding, but they still take several weeks to progress through a raid, right? So they do Hellfire Citadel as a norm. They are classing themselves as a normal raiding guild with heroic aspirations, and they go through Hellfire Citadel, and it takes them, let's say, 2 months to complete. Okay, let's give them a decent run through. Takes them 2 months to complete, 8 weeks. 8 resets before they get to the final boss and they actually manage to defeat that final boss. To turn around and now say, now you've defeated it on normal, time to do heroic, folks, it's kind of more of a, than a yay kind of element to it.
I loved how in Wrath of the Lich King, all of the fights were like normal mode, but they had a mechanic which you could activate the hard mode. I really liked that.
Ghostcrawler shat all over that a few weeks ago in some tweets. He said it wasn't practical for them to do. I liked that. I thought it worked really well. Do you want to kill the heart and you know, going to hard mode in Alduar and stuff like that. I like that. I thought that worked very organically.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a very organic way of changing the difficulty of a raid fight without feeling as if you're compiling difficulty upon difficulty upon difficulty.
I feel with WoW raiding, at the high end, it's probably as difficult as it ever has been in the game. It's probably, in terms of complexity at the high end, it's really challenging. It's great for the hardcore player. But in terms of raiding overall, for everyone, I feel as though as the game's gone on from Villa and Vanilla and TBC and Raf, I feel as though it's just kind of got worse and worse for the average player.
Well, Paragon have packed it in now, of course.
Yeah.
Paragon announced that they're not going to bother raiding. This is a guild that challenges for top spot. And when they turn around and go, look, you know, we can't get the level of player to do Mythic. That's essentially what they said, isn't it?
It's because the kind of recruitment pool for players is much lower now because...
And the complexity level is so high.
Yeah, because people do LFR, they feel as though they've seen the content and they don't want to really go into normal heroic because there's so many different difficulty levels. Why would someone finish heroic and then think, okay, I want to go into mythic now, because that's like three difficulties that they've cleared the raid on.
Mm.
People don't want to do that.
Yeah, you're just doing the same stuff for slightly better gear, and the fact of the matter is gear is complete and utterly irrelevant. It doesn't matter if you're somebody who's kitted out in full mythic gear and I'm in 705 level gear. It doesn't matter. Do you know why it doesn't matter? Because I can kill everything in the outside world within a couple of seconds of you killing it in the outside world. There's no challenge in the outside world. So great, you know, you look gorgeous in your mythic tier gear. You look lovely. I'm not going to dispute that. Well done to you, and you look smashing. But I can kill shit just as good as you can kill shit out here in the world. Because its gear is just utterly irrelevant. There's not, to me, when I played back in Burning Crusade, even getting tier gear was something to aim for. Just
yeah, you kind of saw someone out in the world with it and it's like, wow.
Just like, oh my god, they must be fucking awesome. But now it's just like, and I don't think it's so much that we've seen it all before now, but because they throw out tier gear left, right, and center, it's not really that thing to aspire to. And because the external world content doesn't involve any challenge at all, it doesn't matter if I'm in tier gear and I'm fighting next to somebody in some 695 baleful stuff. They'll kill it just as quick as I kill it. Might be second and a half behind me, but you know, in the grand scale of life, we're pretty much doing it at the same time.
So obviously as more games are coming out and stuff, how long do you feel as though World of Warcraft will remain popular and on top? And can you see the game ever dying?
Well, I think they tried their damnedest to kill it with Warlords, I mean, to be perfectly honest with you. I think it's not just a loss of subscribers with Warlords of Draenor. I don't think Blizzard quite understand the level of respect that they've lost.
Yeah.
With the community, because they have shown a lot of pomp and arrogance and disdain for their customer base. Developers lashing out at their customer base this expansion for what is terrible, pathetic work, which they're expecting people to pay a subscription fee for. I think anyone that has spoken out against this expansion absolutely has a right to, because it's been garbage. It's not been bad, it's not been okay, it's not been mediocre, it's been garbage, utter garbage. And it's insulting that it actually has the World of Warcraft moniker, and it's absolutely insulting that Blizzard have expected people to pay subscription fee for this expansion, because it's been that dour. And so with developers lashing with no apology, there's been zero apology. The nearest we've come to an apology is things haven't worked out how we hoped they would. That's the nearest we've come to an apology. with Warlords of Draenor, because, you know, I don't know whether it's arrogance, whether or not it's that they don't want to accept a blame. You know, if they admit, if they say sorry, then they're in essence admitting fault, and does that open them up to lawsuits and yada yada, you know, all that kind of bullshit nowadays. So I think it's not just a matter of sub loss. I think it's a matter of people have lost faith in Blizz. I think people have lost respect for Blizz. You're seeing other developers and games out there who are trying their hardest. You can see that. You can see them trying their hardest, and I think people are being more won over by these titles because of the fact that they do see the love, they do see the desire of these developers to produce good content for you, to and keep it coming, you know, coming at a regular basis, not twice every two fucking years, Blizz. You know, you kind of get the idea there. So if Legion, I can see Legion getting a pop, of course, obviously, but I can also see it having a colossal drop off. And I don't mean drop off because of Legion being bad. I just mean, or just a drop off now because people are just like, I'm going to buy it to see what it's like. And then after 30 days, 60 days, I've seen enough. Bang. And then it's going to have this huge bang now, because I don't think WoW can create depth of content anymore. I don't think there's depth of content that they can do that. And that is a massive problem for them, because if they have put all this effort into Legion, let's say they really do put effort into Legion, and people start just leaving after 60 days, they're in dire straits. Because is that going to then affect the current subscribers? Are the current subscribers then going to be penalized for that by cut contents and patches to cost save and blah, blah, blah?
I feel like it's going to take a lot for WoW to really hit the point where the game dies, because a lot of people have insane fandom for this game.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous. Like, even people defend Warlords. They just defend it so hard, even though it was so fucking shit. And it's like, if you're defending this expansion, then
you'd defend Hitler.
Yeah, you could defend anything. And they won't try other games and stuff. So I feel as though
if you want to defend Warlords, Bill Cosby wants to hire you as a lawyer.
I feel like World of Warcraft could survive alone just on the insane fandom fans who will defend anything Blizzard does.
Yeah.
Because there's a fucking ridiculous amount of them that are only interested in Blizzard games and won't try anything else.
Oh, absolutely.
So the game, I can't see it dying anytime soon.
Yeah.
But I can see a lot of players that are more objective and can kind of appreciate a game. They'll enjoy WoW, for example, but they're not blinded by fandom. Mm. I can see those people maybe going away, especially if Legion is as bad as Warlords.
I can't see that. I mean, I don't know fucking hell.
I don't think it will be, though.
Yeah, I just cannot see anything being as bad as Legion. But I do also recall saying, I don't think we can get a worse expansion than Mists. Because Mists was just like, Mists wasn't terrible. Mists was just like average. It was just such an average expansion. There's a couple of great moments in it, but as a whole, so average. And then, of course, the massive, massive content drought. And I can remember saying on stream and stuff like that, I think, you know, we're going to come... Something special's got to happen to get a worse expansion than this. Boy, did they pull something special out.
I think they've set the bar so low.
Yeah.
It's not going to be hard for Legion to be better than Warlords.
Put it this way. If Legion is worse than Warlords, what the literal fuck? It's just like, I can't... This is the point. I can't even imagine how it could be worse than Warlord. I literally, my brain cannot fathom how they could actually make it worse. That just kind of shows how bad Warlords is. But yeah, you are absolutely spot on with the fandom. It's something I've always maintained, that there will always come a point with the World of Warcraft that sub numbers will just stop dropping, and it will hit its plateau level. It will hit its fandom level. That could be 2.5 million, that could be 3 million, it could be 1 million, you know, whatever it may be, there is going to come a plateau point where that it won't budge, because that will be your staunch Blizz lovers faux life. We don't care what you do, good, bad, it's just Blizz all the way, baby. I stick Blizz shaped objects up my bum.
Yeah, and some people, like, that have been subscribed for 10 years and they don't want to unsubscribe because...
But there's so much investment in characters, so much time, money, effort. It's scary to a lot of players. You know, it's legitimately scary, and not just scary, but there has been a bond created between them and their account, because they've had this account for 10 years. They've had friends for 2 years. You know, WoW is five times longer in their life, as a five times a more pivotal role in their life than a friend of 2 years. And so, yeah, I think there's an element that they will never, ever, ever, ever leave the game. Now, the World of Warcraft might adapt to that. It might go free to play, you know, in a few years and operate off a pure microtransaction system and all that kind of jazz. But yeah, it will roll on, but it's a matter of how it will roll on, in what capacity. But I certainly think it's lost its crown as top MMO. I think Final Fantasy XIV has that right now. I think it's the best MMO on the marketplace.
For me, it's Black Desert.
And it's operating off a subscription-based model. So you'd never feel as if it's pay to win, because it's a subscription-based model. Black Desert, I think, no, it's got to prove itself. It's really got to prove itself. I think SWTOR is a great little game that's so underrated, because it's got amazing stories. It's like the MMO that you don't need, people. It's kind of like the MMO that Blizzard desperately wish they were.
My problem with Final Fantasy was I just found the combat to be more boring than WoW's. It's tab targeting, but the global cooldown is a lot longer, and I just can't take it. It's so long, dude.
It's a little bit slower than WoW, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. If you've seen, like, the raiding, like the Alexander raiding and stuff, I'm not trying to derail the video here, but if you see, like, the Alexander raiding, and if you see the dungeon stuff, then it actually really takes into account about the cooldowns, and it really takes into account the fact of when you are casting and something, then the ability is popping up on your screen that's going to hit on you, you've got to move immediately. It's like you can't stay around, finish your cast, then move out, because it kind of like an ability in Final Fantasy 14, once it's been on you for like a second and a half, it's pretty much locked on for life. So it doesn't matter if you get outside the circle just before it explodes. No, you've been locked onto. You're going to take that damage. And in Final Fantasy XIV, damages are so much harder than WoW. You know, you take way more damage than WoW. You can't solo elites and stuff like that in Final Fantasy XIV.
I feel like I need to just push myself to get to end game, because because everyone just tells me the leveling is a bit of a grind and it's a bit of a nightmare, but once you get to level 50, the combat gets a lot more fun. I got to like level 28, and I was so bored with the leveling and the combat that
it's each their own. I mean, this is the beauty of choice, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is the beauty of choice. You're not happy with WoW, you're not happy with Final Fantasy 14, you go play Black Desert. I'm not happy with WoW. I'm you know, teasing with Black Desert. It's got good stuff, it's got bad stuff, so I'm sort of like, okay, it's this and that, but my go-to then becomes Final Fantasy. Somebody else could use ESO as their go-to game, or SWTOR as their go-to game. That's the beauty of choice. And 10 years ago when World of Warcraft came out, that wasn't there.
Yeah.
That wasn't there at all. The competition wasn't there. They did produce a great game, but it was a great game in those days for its time. And all that kind of stuff, but they still didn't have the competition. If 10 years ago you had Final Fantasy XI that was out, but that was a 2-3-year-old game by the time World of Warcraft came out, you had EverQuest, which Blizzard took heavily from the construction of World of Warcraft. And they continue to look at other games and try and pick parts. All MMOs do that. They look at other MMOs and they go, what's working in these games and how can we adapt it to our own title? But nowadays, you know, we've got MMOs coming out of our backside, and if one of them isn't delivering, there's plenty of choice to go elsewhere.
Yeah. So I've got an interesting question for you. So if you magically became CEO of World of Warcraft, where would you take the game? What would you do to fix the issues?
If I was CEO of World of Warcraft right now, I wouldn't change a thing, and I'd take all the money that they're making. Because that's what they're in it for right now, a big fat fucking paycheck. And I would take that paycheck. Oh yeah, I would tap that paycheck. Look, if I was the CEO of World of Warcraft and I wanted, I would try and reintroduce a little bit of fucking humility back into the company for a start. One thing that I think is the worst thing about Warlords hasn't been the content, hasn't been the lack of care to the game. It's actually been the lack of give a shit to the community. That's the worst thing for me about Warlords, because they've produced something which is clearly subpar. Whether you want to admit it, you know, even the most staunch of WoW supporters know in their heart this is fucking subpar trash. And it's just been their complete and utter lack and disdain to the community in this. Their reluctance to get engage them, their reluctance to apologize, their reluctance to address the problems and try and rectify them in this expansion, instead of saying, well, yeah, we'll look at it for Legion and things like that, because people are paying money every month. They are handing over physical cash to you every month, and it just feels as if they've taken the piss. So I would definitely introduce a wee bit of humility. I would probably have a fucking clear out as well, because I don't, you know, whether or not this is a directive from Activision and there's nothing they can do to stop that, then it becomes a different kettle of fish. Because I still think Activision's got a hand in here. I think there's something going on, although they'll never admit it. I do think there's something going on with Activision that is having some bearing on how the World of Warcraft moves as a game. But if Activision wasn't there, then I'd probably have a huge fucking clear out. There is just so much ego that seems to be in this company at the moment, and it's only harming the game.
It feels as though they're under pressure from Activision just to make as much money as they could, whereas at the start they just wanted to make a world that they wanted to play in themselves.
But this is what happens when you're beholden to shareholders. The customer doesn't become the most important part of the equation anymore. It should be company to customer. That is how it should work when you're producing a product. But it's not. It's company to shareholder to customer.
I think that's a problem with almost every MMO nowadays as well. It's just a problem in the industry, hence why everything's becoming so heavily monetized.
Yeah,
we're seeing ridiculous cash shops in every single MMO almost.
Whack does
minus it's not that bad. There is way worse. Arcage was fucking horrendous. That's way worse. Guild Wars 2 probably has the best and most ethical business model.
That's an ethical game. Yeah,
that I can think of. At least they've kind of
Guild Wars 2. I've never used you as an example in this video. I do apologise. I quite enjoyed my Guild Wars 2 time. I quite enjoyed my Guild Wars. I loved doing the whole platforming element and finding the vistas and stuff.
Yeah, I love that. That's so much fun. Yeah. I think I'm gonna cover that game in my leveling series next, because I'm kind of getting the itch.
I promise next time I'm using examples, I'll use you as well. But yeah, it's when everything's beholden to shareholders, and so many companies now are shareholder based. It's just money.
Honestly, what I'd like to see happen with WoW is it would be nice if they could have a kind of clear up and clear out and change of attitude. But I'd like to see the game kind of update itself almost. I think it'd be awesome if maybe we get to the point where we kill Sargeras somehow, we blow up the world, and maybe we get WoW 2 set like a few hundred years after a time of peace or something.
Yeah,
that's what I would honestly like.
Is if you put WoW 2 10 years ago with 10 years ago attitude, you would be drooling at the mouth for the game. But when you put it into today's age of shareholder, then it'd be like, how would they make a WoW 2 now? How would they look to monetize it? What would the pay model be? And when all those are the first questions which are being asked, it's always the customer which is going to get shafted.
It'd be really cool if, like, once WoW hit a certain point where they lost a lot of subscribers, maybe do that kind of thing where they hit a time of peace after defeating the ultimate enemy. Then they make Warcraft 4 to set the kind of story for WoW 2, just like they did with Warcraft 3 and WoW. That's what I'd do, and then have WoW 2 with a similar kind of system, but a lot more updated, like how it was in vanilla and TBC with the raiding progression, one raid difficulty kind of thing. Just kind of start again like that. I know a lot of people are heavily against the idea of a WoW 2 because they don't want to lose their character progression.
Yeah.
That kind of goes to show just how kind of invested people are.
Yeah.
That they would rather just have the game have an update so they can keep their character rather than have a completely new game. But Blizzard have spoke about the idea of WoW 2 before, and I think it was at Gamescom either last year or the year before. And when interviewed about it, they said they've talked about it a lot, but they're conscious that MMO sequels have always been massive failures. But that's not always true. Like, Guild Wars 2, I wouldn't consider that a failure.
No, I think it's done all right from what I can gather. And
the vast majority of them are quite bad, though.
World of Warcraft has the brand. It has the brand, which other games companies don't have. You know, if you treat the brand right, the brand's going to look after you. If you don't treat the brand right, it's going to implode. And I think the WoW 2 is probably less likely to happen now because of the events of the last few years with Blizz, with Warlords and such. Because people would be like, well, this is actually a really good jumping off point now because we've been fucked up the bum for the last few years. So they'll probably just do the same on a new game. So there's unfortunately that potential likelihood.
And obviously when you're at the mercy of shareholders and stuff, you kind of go into games which cost a lot less to develop and make a lot more money. I mean, we've got Hearthstone.
Yeah.
Heroes of the Storm.
They've just bought out the Candy Crush company, so does that mean they're looking now to do more mobile-based games? Lots of heavy monetized little silly games like that.
I'm really looking forward to Overwatch, though, and I'm glad they didn't go with the free-to-play model for that. That's at least something.
Yeah, we'll see, but there's got to be some pay structure behind it somewhere.
Oh, there is. You kind of buy lots of vanity items. I'm actually really happy with the business model they've gone for with that game.
Is it just skins?
Like all future, future heroes and maps are free.
Mm-hmm.
Which I think is fantastic because it's like just vanity stuff.
So they're not going to hit you with any Overwatch expansions or anything?
If it is an expansion, it'll be like a vanity thing. I don't know. But from everything we've seen so far, it does look like a pretty ethical business model. And it's a fun game. Have you had the chance to play it yet?
Yeah, I played a bit of it. I found it was equal parts fun, equal parts frustrating. I'm going to lap over with something I did with DD the other day. But because I never play first-person shooters on a PC. I never do.
Okay.
Or if it's a first-person shooter on a PC that doesn't involve multiplayer, I play with a pad. I use my pad. I've never been a keyboard mouse first-person shooter person. Just never have. So playing Overwatch with a pad put me on the PC, because that's where I played it, put me at a distinct disadvantage to your hardened keyboard mouse crew.
Yeah, definitely.
So I had, you know, some games good, some games I'd just be wrecked and wrecked and wrecked and wrecked and wrecked, and it got really, really annoying. But because it's coming out on console, which is good, I like, you know, if I get Overwatch on the PlayStation 4, because I could easily buy Overwatch, you know, I could possibly get it. At least everybody there is going to be using a pad.
Yeah, at least you're on a level playing field.
So it's a level playing field, and that may make it a wee bit more fun. But yeah, I just remember I started off on Overwatch good, and then by the end of the weekend, it was just wreck game after wreck game after wreck game, and it was just driving me insane.
I think it's really hard for new players. When I first started playing it, I wanted to smash my computer. It made me so angry.
Yeah, it will just bite your hand off or whatever you do, you know.
Yeah, but then as I kind of got up to speed with the pace of the game, I started to really enjoy it.
Yeah. Yeah, it had its ups and downs. I mean, I think it's kind of being messiahed a wee bit. I don't think it's the next coming of Christ that it's been quite made out to be. You know, it's a nice looking first person shooter that's nice.
It's the kind of thing I'll just jump on if I've got a spare half an hour or so.
Yeah, but
the
that's
games are quite
it.
Short.
It's not something I would just hammer. It'd be like I'd maybe play once a week for half an hour maybe, and that'd be it. But that's okay for Blizz. That's fine because it's a purchase model, so I can play it at my leisure. It's not as if I have to level up characters or anything like that.
No.
So it's exactly.
So, is there anything else you want to add?
Not really. Let's sort everything out. No. No. I think Blizzard dug themselves a massive hole in Warlords of Draenor. Huge hole. And it's going to be a matter of whether or not they can climb out. But I think people are going to be so more wary of Legion, and I think it's going to have probably a bigger loss rates than what purely organically now, because people are just having a look at it and then going, so they've got to do something special. But there's just got to be a breadth of content now. There has to be a breadth of content.
Something someone asked me a few days ago was, LazyPeon, are you excited for WoW Legion? And my answer was, I'm not excited. I'll play it anyway, though.
Hmm.
That's just kind of how I feel about
it. There's no hype. I'm participating in the alpha at the moment, and it's not as if I get it. You know, there's no excitement there for me. It's kind of like, yeah, coming on, doing a bit of this, doing a bit of that. But I think that's partly to do with the fact that there's no end game at the moment. It's just leveling and the dungeons. So there's no end game at the moment.
I'm looking forward to the PvP in Legion because I have so many characters. I've got like a character of each class.
Well, that's out now. The PvP server's up.
Oh, is it? I need to check that out. Does it scale you to 110?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I need to get in there. Because I love playing multiple classes, and the problem I've had in Warlords is I can't gear loads of different classes, but now in Legion with you kind of being scaled differently, I can play all of my classes and still be competitive because it's not much of a impact of gear. So I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah, that's up.
If anything keeps me playing, it'll be that.
Well, I've got my Warlock, 810 item level. It's got just short of 2 million health.
Oh my god, the health numbers are so ridiculous.
Yep.
Oh, I don't like that.
Yep.
I'm just going to turn the numbers off in Legion, I think.
Just watch the bar go down. That's all you need to see.
Yeah,
just knocking that about. Yeah, but yeah, that's up. State of the game is in a dire straits, but look, breadth of content I think is the only thing that can save Blizzard, and diversity of difficulty.
Yeah,
otherwise they're never going to retain. They are never going to retain always pandering to the lowest common denominator. It's just never going to retain people.
So that's it for this video, guys. Once again, I'm really sorry for the poor audio quality. I had to reinstall Windows the other day because the latest Nvidia update fucked my computer so hard. So I haven't got all of my settings back to what they originally were. So I'm still working on that. I hope you enjoyed the video anyway. You take it easy and I'll see you again really soon.